Hello, beautiful friend. Welcome back to Trauma Talk. Thanks for joining me here today. I am your host, Joe. I wanted to talk today about a question that often comes up in circles of those who have experienced abuse. It's often asked to me. I often wondered it myself before I was in a relationship. That is the question of when and if at all we should tell the people who we are in intimate relationships with or dating relationships with or anything along those lines that we've experienced trauma, that we are dealing with mental health issues, fill in the blank. This is a really hot button issue for a lot of people, understandably so. I know that it was for me because I felt wrong. I felt broken. I felt different. I felt like damaged goods. I hate that term, but that is honestly what I felt like. And who would want to take that on? Who would want to deal with that? Like, I felt like a burden to myself. So of course I felt like it to other people. So did I really want to share that information with them? And people had hurt me with that information before. When I had shared my story with people and they didn't get it, it was very painful. People used it against me. So why would I want to share that with someone who I might want to share my life with? Like, wouldn't it be easier maybe to just not, to just pretend that it never happened, to just not share that part of my life at all? So I wanted to share my personal opinion on this in this video, and please know I am not giving a recommendation here. You get to make these choices for yourself. You are 100% in control of who knows your story from you, when. No one has the right to knowing all the details of what has happened to you. Please know that. This is what I chose to do, and this is why I chose to do it. And if this helps you, fantastic. And if this doesn't resonate with you, just chuck it out the door. I wanted to date. I wanted to find someone. I always wanted to get married. I felt like that would fit me very well. And I'm married now, and it does. I really enjoy being married. But the process of getting here was challenging. And when I was still dating, I didn't date around a ton, but my strategy, this was super smart, please catch the sarcasm there. My strategy was to just chuck it out really quickly and get it out of the way. So way too early, I would tell people that I had been assaulted, that I had recently gone through trauma, and I tried to like be cool about it and like I was in control of it and like I was good to go, but I wasn't. I was a wreck. I was a mess. I was not okay. And my theory, I think, was if I could get that out of the way at first, then they could leave quickly. Then I wouldn't be so hurt further down the road, right? But I see the flip side of the argument too, where people I have known have waited years to tell their significant others that they have experienced abuse or had dealt with PTSD or fill in the blank. And I get both sides of that, but the route that I took was to go really early with it. And when I met my husband, we talked for weeks. We were sort of friends, but we were obviously interested in each other. And when we had our first real date, we sat and we talked for, this is not a joke, 6 hours. We closed out a bar, and we sort of put everything on the table because we had both gone through a lot at that point in our lives. And I told him, not in detail, but just in a broad sweeping brushstroke, hey, I was sexually assaulted. It's really impacted me and I'm trying to deal with it. The end. And he told me some stuff about his life as well. And because we were both on board with being like upfront, open, and honest, it worked. And we spent years working through things. I've talked about some of that on this channel, working through both of our things and figuring out how to communicate through it and all of that. And I would not do it any other way. But here's the thing. I got really lucky in that because the person that I was sharing that with ended up being a safe person. I didn't 100% know that at the time. I mean, we can't ever 100% know that, but I took a risk in hoping that this person that I had known for like a month and a half was someone who might be understanding. The vibes that I had picked up from them made me think that maybe they would try to get it, maybe they would try to listen, and I was right. But I wasn't always right. I haven't always been right. And it's a really scary thing to do. So when is it safe to share that information? What are best practices when it comes to sharing, hey, I've experienced trauma, or hey, I'm dealing with PTSD, or hey, you know, I have anxiety and depression, and sometimes I have panic attacks, and this is what it looks like, or, you know, this is what I've experienced, and this is how it affects me, and here's why I want you to know. How I've always looked at it is, if I'm gonna enter into a relationship with someone, this is something that's really affected me. And there are times where I've tried to downplay that, but it's never worked long term, because if I'm honest with myself, this forged a portion of my identity for a long time. It's less of that now, but it was a big part of who I was for a couple years, trying to figure out who I was after going through that, because it changed so much of me. And PTSD was real bad, and depression was real bad. And so struggling through like the muck and the darkness of it was like my life. And so not to share that with someone who I'd be spending most of my days with, who I'd be spending the majority of, you know, my life with, as I chose that, didn't make sense to me. If you were my friend and we were sitting down to coffee and you asked me, hey, I think I'm gonna start seeing this person, you know, we knew that you had gone through something and you were saying, I don't know when I should tell them. I think my recommendation as a person, not as a professional, because I'm not one, would be if you feel like they're a safe person, maybe after you've known them for a little while, after you've gotten comfortable with them, talk to them about it. Test the waters, not in excruciating detail. Something that I've tried to do with other people in my life is pick up on how they respond to similar subjects. Like if we see a poster that has something to do with PTSD, or if we watch a movie and there's a weird scene that's uncomfortable that has to do with someone being hurt in the way that I was hurt, how do they respond to that? You know, I try to pick up on that stuff. What kind of jokes do they make? That's not always gonna tell you what kind of person someone is at all, but it can give you some kind of indication how they might respond to your story. If you get a bad impression from those reactions, maybe they aren't the person to talk to about this. Maybe they aren't a safe person for this subject. If their reactions are more hopeful or open-minded, maybe they are. And again, there's no way to know that. It's always a risk, and I think part of the decision process is about risk management. So trying to pick up on those things as much as you can, and at least spending a little bit of time with them, whether that's a date or two or three or fill in the blank. For me personally, another thing to take into consideration is how much this is actively affecting things. So if you are, let's just say for instance, 5 years past something, and you feel like you're in a decent place with it and it's not affecting most aspects of your life, you feel like you're okay, maybe it isn't the most pressing thing to bring up. Maybe it isn't the first or second or 18th thing you talk about. Maybe it's something you bring up down the line as, hey, this is a part of who I am, if that's something you feel comfortable talking about. But if you went through something 5 years ago and you're still very actively processing it and dealing with it like I was, maybe that is a conversation, because I can think of situations where I was with friends and something triggered me and I had a panic attack or was triggered and needed to get away from a situation and got really, really weird. If you didn't know what was going on, did not want to try to spend energy in those moments trying to explain to people what was going on. I wanted them to be aware of it. So if something is more actively affecting you, maybe there's more urgency to discuss it with them so that they can know how to take care of you, so that they can know what to do for you, so that they can look into it and understand it a little bit better. Maybe those things aren't considerations at all, but a piece of it that I would personally for myself take into consideration is how much do I feel like this is presently part of my life? And the answer for many past years has been a pretty large part, because I've been trying to work through it. Okay, so it's a few hours later and I was editing this video and I realized I forgot to mention a very important point. I think it's important to take into consideration when you are entering into a relationship with another person, the whole point of the word relationship is that you're going to be interacting with another individual, is their feelings. Of course, we want to protect ourselves. I think that's mission one in any relationship. That is mission one in any kind of relationship. You want to stay safe mentally, emotionally, physically, spiritually, fill in the blank. But if you are going to be sharing your life, if you're going to be sharing your part of yourself with another person, you do need to consider them. So for me, it was important to think what type of relationship I was going to have with this person. For instance, with Brian, who is now my husband, I knew that this was going to be a serious relationship, but that's what I wanted it to be. I wanted us to have an open and honest and vulnerable relationship, even if I didn't know how to do that yet. And so I did want to share personal information when I felt it was right. If you or you and a partner want an open, honest, vulnerable relationship, I think that's a really important tip to take into account. If I didn't share this information that was important to me, that was important to my life and about who I was with someone who I wanted to know me, that felt eventually like it would sort of be a breach of trust to some extent. I guess the essence of what I'm saying here is I think it's important to take into consideration the feelings of the person who you are with. Again, your safety in all regards is paramount. But if this is a serious kind of relationship that you want or that you are pursuing, how important is that openness to you? How important is that openness to the other person? How much is this affecting you? Do they need to know that? How are they going to feel about that? How do you want them to feel about that? How do you want communication to go? We aren't going to know unless we have those conversations. And I think that that is a very important piece to wonder about, to think about, to ponder on, and to come up with your own answer to. So those are a couple things that I take into consideration, but please, 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 please know that my opinion doesn't mean anything to your life if you don't want it to. So if none of this resonated with you, like I said in the beginning, just trash it. You know what's best in this situation. If you feel like it's a good idea, go for it. If you do not feel like it's a good idea and you do not want to do it, don't go for it. No one has a right to your story. No one has a right to the details of your trauma. You are in control of that, and please remember that. Thanks for listening, guys. Let me know if this was helpful. Let me know if you have any other ideas or tips or tricks that might be helpful. What do you think about this? How have you handled this? How would you want to handle this? I look forward to hearing from you guys. Thank you so much for listening. I really appreciate you guys. I love you. I'm thinking about you, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye, guys.